for beginners. But before I start, you need to learn what option selling is all about. Option selling is like playing hide and seek. Okay? You have to run away from the market. You have to guess what will not happen in the market. And if you ask me, option selling is very easy and a fool's game. You need not be very intelligent or you have some special analytical skills to guess what will not happen. Okay? And let me tell you, guessing what will not happen is very easy than guessing what will happen. Okay? Now for example, let's say tomorrow we have a cricket match and Virat Kohli is batting. Okay? I can guarantee and tell you that Virat Kohli will not hit a double century. Which is right, right? Yes, he might hit, I don't know. But what is the probability? Okay. Virat Kohli or any batsman will hit a double century probably once in 100 matches or 200 matches. And I can tell you, Jasprit Bumrah will not take a hat. How many matches do you think Jasprit Bumrah will come and take a hat-trick? Okay. He might have taken a hat-trick in the past, but he might have taken a hat-trick in probably 1 or 2 or 10 matches in all the matches he has played. To be frank, I don't have the stats. I can tell you, tomorrow Virat Kohli will not hit 6 sixes in an over. How many matches do you think Virat Kohli has hit 6 sixes in an over? So option selling is all about guessing this thing. Okay. So let me tell how it is done in stock. Now let's say Reliance is at 2000 rupees. I can tell you that Reliance will not go to 1000 rupees or it will not go to 3000 rupees in this month, which is approximately 50% increasing and 50% falling, which may not happen. Yes, unless if there is an unprecedented situation, like if Mukesh Ambani is serious or if there is any world war which will happen. Yes, in that case it might happen, but unless those things happen, the chance of these things happening is very less. But here, the profit what you make will also be small because you are betting this with someone else and the person on the other side is not a fool. Even he knows that Reliance will not fall 50% or not go up 50%. But you will make a profit. Now, the profit what you make depends on how close bets you take. Okay, so there is a saying, option selling is like sitting in front of a campfire. If you sit very close, then you will burn your hands, and if you sit very far, you will not get the heat. So you have to sit at the right distance so that you get the right amount of heat and you are warm. Okay. So now I took an example of Reliance. So now let's say Reliance is at 2000. Now you can sell options which are by telling that it will not go to 3000, or you can sell options and tell it will not come to 1000. So if you are actually taking this bet, you will have to sell the put of 1000. Okay, sell. If you are taking this bet, then you will have to sell the call of this one. Okay. Now, yes, if you win in the bet, like if Reliance does not go to 3000 or if Reliance does not go to 1000, you will make a profit. Now, if you want to increase your profit, then you have to be closer to the strike. So, for example, here if you make 1000 rupees. Let's assume that you make a profit of 1000 rupees by selling this call option.
if you sell something here, which is let's say 2800, call, you will be selling, you'll be making 3000. If you sell something here, let's say 2100, you will be making 25,000. But the risk here will be very, very high. As you move closer to the strike, the risk will be very high. Now, we have 20 trading days in a month. So in 20 trading days, the probability of Reliance going to 2100 is very high. Again, these numbers are just examples what I gave you. What I was trying to tell you is, the further you go from the spot, the less will be your profit. Okay. Now you see what are the strikes which is good enough, which will give you more returns than the fixed deposit. If you are good at that, then you can go ahead and do this business. Okay. As I tell you always, stock trading is a business. Now, option selling was actually a rich man's game, because if you want to sell any of the options, before you needed approximately 1 to 2 lakh rupees. Okay. But now, recently, SEBI has come with a new margin scheme, where if you execute any of the hedged positions, then your margin will go down drastically to 40 to 50,000. Now, this business is no more a rich man's business. Okay? So, even with a person with a capital of 40, 50,000 can start this business and master this business. Okay? And make good profit by trading in options. Now, how do you do this thing? So let's just a minute. So now, as I told you, Reliance is at 2000. So you feel that Reliance will not go to 2300. So 2300 call is what you should be selling. Okay. So if you are doing just this trade, then you will be requiring around 1.5 lakh. One to two lakh, okay. But now if you want to reduce the margin, then just buy some deep OTM options. So here you have sold 2300 call. Just buy something which is outside this, which can be approximately 2600. So now for this combined trade, you will be paying just 35 to 45k. Again, you will have to check the margin with the broker. Okay, so approximately it's this way. So your margin has gone down drastically to 1/3. But obviously, your profit also will go down drastically. But the return on your investment can increase. Okay? So now, let's say Reliance lot size is 250. Okay, is the lot size. So now if you have sold 2300 option for let's say 10 rupees, okay. So if you have executed just this trade, then for your let's say 2 lakh capital, if you make a profit, you will be making a profit of 250 into 10, which is 2500. So the ROI in this case is going to be 1.25% on your capital which you have actually invested. Now let's say you have bought 2600 call for let's say 2 rupees. Okay, so you have bought this for 2 rupees, Now you're in this case, the capital which you have deployed is approximately 35k.
Okay.
So you have bought an option for 2 rupees, whereas you have sold an option for 10 rupees. So the net what you have made is 8 rupees. Okay. So if this trade works out, your profit is going to be 8 into 250, which is equal to 2000. Okay. So now your return on investment is going to be approximately 5 to 6%. Isn't this good? And not only this, by doing this, here you will have unlimited loss in the first case. Okay. Now, for example, tomorrow if Reliance hits a jackpot, and for let's say some company like Facebook came and told that they are going to invest heavily in Reliance, okay, then the Reliance might shoot up to 3000. In that case, the loss will be very bad. Okay. But in this case, the loss is going to be limited. Yes, the loss is going to be high, but it is going to be limited. On day one, you will know what is the maximum loss you can incur. Okay. You will know that you are not going to lose even a single rupee more than this. So now, how do beginners take advantage of this system? Okay. So now SEBI has introduced a lot of systems in order to curb retail participation and futures and options. Okay. Other rule is, before, brokers were able to give unlimited leverage to clients, but now SEBI has put a full stop for that, and brokers will not be able to give any leverage to the clients. But they have introduced this margin reduction system, where by doing a hedge, you will be able to reduce your margin. I always suggest you to trade either in Nifty or Bank Nifty, because the liquidity is very good in Nifty and Bank Nifty. I suggest you don't trade in stock options, because slippages can be very bad because stock options are not liquid. Okay. So now let's say Nifty is at 15,000. Okay. Open the option chain of weekly or monthly or whatever you are comfortable with. Just see what is the maximum open interest for the stock. So now let's say the maximum open interest is 15,500 on the call side, okay? And let's say on the put side, the maximum open interest is on 14,500. So if you are a beginner, then you can start with a strategy called iron condor, where you will be taking a bet telling Nifty will not go beyond 15,500, and on the lower side it will not fall below 14,500. This will be the bet which you will be taking. Okay. And how do you take this bet? It is very simple. When you see that the maximum open interest is there for these two strikes, it means that there are a lot of people who believe that this is the range for Nifty for that expiry. Okay. You might be seeing the weekly expiry or monthly expiry, depending on what expiry you see. Okay. So now, when you have the range, you just sell one lot of this. Of 15,500 call, and here also you sell one lot of 14,500 put. And then for doing only this trade, you will need approximately 3 weeks. Okay. But as per the new margin rule of SEBI, to reduce the margin, just buy a call which is outside this and buy a put which is outside this. So here you can select 14,300 put. You buy. Okay. And here you will be buying 15,800. By doing this, the capital required for taking this entire trade is approximately 50 to 60k. Okay, and sometimes when volatility is high, it might even go up to 80k. Okay, but not more than this. Okay, if your capital is less, then you will have to take some directional call. So see what is the market condition. If the markets are trending on the higher side, then probably you can do only this. If the market is falling or if it is in the consolidation phase, then probably you can do this, only this. So by doing only this or this, your capital will get half. So here in this or this case, you will need approximately 40k. So if your capital is within 50, you do either this or this, again depending on the condition. Okay. Now let's say you were wrong. Okay. You expected markets to be within 15,000 to 15,500 and 14,500. What do you do? Okay. There are a lot of adjustment techniques which are there. So I will be doing a separate video on iron condor adjustments. So this is the way to get started into stock market. Okay, don't simply blindly buy some futures or call or put hoping that you will make profit. Whatever those trades you are doing is nothing but gambling. So this is just an introduction for people who want to get into stock options, option selling strategy, option trading strategy. In my further videos, I will be telling you what are the things you have to do if your trade goes wrong. So this is the range what we came out. But you know, markets are crazy. Sometimes it will go and challenge your trades. At that times, what are the adjustments you have to do? What are the trades you have to take? What is the capital requirement? What is the risk management? What are the mindset for all this? I will be doing a separate video on this. So do like and subscribe to my channel. I hope you guys like the video. Thank you for watching.